Hi, everybody. Welcome to the New York Stock Exchange. We are excited to have a special CUBE conversation and a preview to this year's UiPath Fusion. My name is Dave Vellante. I'm here with Michael Atalla, who is the newly minted CMO. Michael, great to have you on. I'm so excited about this year's Fusion.
Yeah, I am too, Dave. Thank you so much for having me on the show. I appreciate it.
You know, UiPath, this is my seventh UiPath Fusion. I remember the first one, I missed one. First one I did was at the Fontainebleau in Florida. It was an amazing show. We knew at that time that UiPath was on a trajectory that was uncanny. And you know, you guys were doing automation before it was cool to do automation. Everybody wants to automate now. So let me start with you and your background. What attracted you to UiPath and why now?
Yeah, I mean, you have me at a huge disadvantage with your seventh Fusion as I get ready for my first. You talk about automation and sort of doing automation before it's cool. But, you know, I got to say, for me, automation is the thing that drew me to it, not just because of the rapid growth and the sort of dominance of the robotic process automation space that UiPath has had. But, man, go all the way back in history, Dave. Like, automation has been the core of so many instances of large scale business and industry transformation. Like, we could go geek out over history and talk Roman viaducts, right? We could go into like the origin of the assembly line and car manufacturing. But at every point in time that automation has transformed something, the whole industry has moved with it, and the whole world and sometimes economies have moved with it. I think AI and the sort of rapid growth of the age of AI is another one of those moments that not just will be now automation's chance to transform industry again, but in fact, the industry is going to transform what automation means and what agentic automation is and what orchestration is. And bluntly, I want to be here for it. I want to be at UiPath for this because I can't think of a better place to have a front row seat to this phase of industry transformation.
I feel like UiPath was often misunderstood. I mean, you recreated the robotic process automation market. You did some really key strategic acquisitions, like Process Gold, which got you into automation, enterprise automation. I think Gartner called it hyper automation. You guys defined that category sort of for the next wave. So now and you guys have always been able to, respond to industry trends. We're now in another wave, of course, of AI. So how should we think about UiPath and the category, if you will, that you're in? You're a C-level executive. How do you explain that?
Yeah, I mean, that's a great articulation of sort of history and where we are today. I think, simply put, UiPath is going to be the leader in orchestrating business processes in the AI era. And I think that word orchestration is really at the heart of what is changing in the world of process automation in this era, right? It's more than just automation. It's more about piecing apart a process and taking those individual components and figuring out what to do with them. It's about orchestrating across an ecosystem of players, of infrastructure players, of application players. And no one else truly is building on the foundation of trust that we have in place from our origins in the RPA space with the technical capabilities that we've got and the ability and willingness to add value across that entire ecosystem. Willingness is an important point, right? Because we have a lot of proprietary and platform-dependent automation players out there, and it will be a solution like ours that orchestrates across them that, in fact, empowers businesses to truly transform in this era.
So what's interesting about that is, of course, UiPath is kind of the Switzerland of process, the horizontal play. People always say that data has gravity, but you don't often hear that process has gravity, and that's key because as you point out, you're in a position now to be that orchestrator across all these different sort of silos. And so we're going to hear hopefully at Fusion from customers. In fact, I know we're going to, because you were the first company ever at an event, and we've done thousands of events in theCUBE. First time ever I've seen a customer on stage introducing the event, where the first conversation that the audience had was with the customer. So you're a customer first. So help us understand how we should think about this year's Fusion, what we can expect.
Yeah, I mean, well, certainly, you're going to see our customer-centric approach shine through again. That, you know, often the main stage of an event like this is full of company executives taking turns sort of waxing philosophical about vision, and you're going to see us bring customers on stage from the very beginning of the day. Like, day one is going to start, and we're going to have longtime customers like CSL Behring, JPMC, Voya, WEX, getting up on stage, sharing the stage with Daniel, our founder and CEO, sharing the stage with our chief product officer, so that we can tell the story of how UiPath is supporting business transformation through the voices of our customers. I think, you know, beyond that, Fusion is an important event for us to explain our Act Two vision, right? This change and transformation of what UiPath is for our customers. And, you know, if I had to articulate what I really hope customers will take away from it and attendees will take away from it, it's threefold. One, that orchestration is the center of gravity, has become the center of gravity in business process automation, particularly as this ecosystem has grown as dense as it has. Attendees should come away with sort of understanding the playbook for how to ensure they have this right tool, right technology fit in their approach to business transformation and thinking about process automation. And they should come away confident that there are customers like the ones I mentioned that are leading the way in this transformation, that they can rely on to prove that transformation is both possible, practical, affordable, efficient, and results in real business outcomes at the end of the day. If you know, that's sort of the way I think about piecing together what this event is all about.
Yeah, so in my experience over the years, I've seen the attendee list obviously grow. You've got an amazing ecosystem as well. You know, the partners are always prominent. They're prominent guests on theCUBE. They oftentimes come on with customers. The customers talk about the quality impacts that they've had on their business. The hardcore ROI, you know, you hear so much today, Michael, about, you know, the lack of ROI in AI. What can we expect in that context? I mean, again, we're used to returns on the work that you guys have done with customers, and we've heard it firsthand. I've got dozens and dozens of examples. What should we expect to hear in terms of the economics of what you guys are going to be able to deliver to customers?
Well, that will come back, Dave, to the way we tell our stories through customers. We will have a good conversation with a handful of customers in our opening day keynote that is about the real returns people are seeing and the real efficiency gains they're seeing. I think you'll also hear us talk about some of the efficiency and effectiveness of the overall agentic orchestration space in the context of key industry partners that go, you know, frankly, breaking news early, like some of the most marquee and most relevant players in the ecosystem today that will really be alongside UiPath in telling the story. So we hope to use that evidence to really convey the real value that is being proven every day in our customer environments.
Yeah, and having the advantage of seeing the trajectory over the better part of a decade, you know, when Fusion first started, you know, there was a few partners there, but then it really exploded when the partners realized, you know, what the opportunity was here to have a business impact. So I'm super excited about the ecosystem, always have been. The other thing about Fusion is you guys mix it up. It's not just the standard, you know, set of, you know, booths or, you know, partner stands, et cetera. It's very clean. And it's very inviting. And so I'm really excited about that. You're going to have analysts there. You're going to have media there. What else can you tell us about the sort of the branding and the content and the community at Fusion?
Well, I'll tell you, I feel like you give me an opportunity to celebrate my events team a little bit. And I'll tell you, like, if I've learned anything over the course of three decades of going to trade shows and running events like this, it's that if you feed people well, it's amazing how much the quality of experience improves. So I would highly recommend any attendee walks in the door in their first couple of hours, get in there and find what we're calling the nosh spots, because I say it lightheartedly, but the truth is, in my experience, the way you feed people at these events, keep them energized and keep them focused, is has a huge bit to do with how they experience the event. So I think that'll be a big part of it. And you're right, it's part of the experience being far more centered on an attendee experience versus sort of like a a big show that has a lot of lights and videos and sounds. It really is about bringing the community together in a way that makes them comfortable, makes them feel connected, that they can come away learning something and feeling like they're part of something at the end of the event.
Good food, good drink, and great content always make for a fantastic event. What do you? How are you going to, when you look back, what does a successful Fusion 2025 look like to the new CMO? What are you hoping to look back and be able to say that maybe, you know, other events might not be able to say, or even Fusion might not have been able to say in the past?
Yeah, when I talk about these events with my teams over the course of my career, right, I'm always talking about the fact that we do an event for the people in the room, and then we kind of do a parallel event for the rest of the world. So if I focus on the rest of the world, which is where that main stage keynote and the live stream will do of it to everyone that's not in the room goes, how we tell those stories effectively and how they are told outside of the walls of the conference center itself, how they show up in the press, how customers start talking about them, how they show up in social media, how they're amplified. Like, I'll be looking at that level of messaging and amplification outside of the event, because at the end of the day, we do this event for the thousands in the room and then for the rest of the UiPath ecosystem around us and the partners and customers around them. In the room, I want people to walk away with a deep understanding of our vision, but also the training and education puts them in a position to go act on that vision. And so training, education, certification, fundamental to what's happening in that room. And I'll look at the volume of customers that are taking part of those training and certification tests, the people that are participating in hands-on labs. We added a day of hands-on labs to this event. On the day three of it, I'm super keen to see the level of participation and engagement there, because I think training, certification, fundamental to our role in this industry transformation. And then the big thing that I think is unique to UiPath is the level of trust that our customers have put in us over the course of the last decade. I want them to walk away confident that they're still placing their trust in the right vendor and the right partner in this age of agentic automation and orchestration. And so I'll look for how that trust takes shape in the way customers vote with their checkbooks, of course, but also in the way they talk about us and the way they review us, in the way they partner with us over time.
You know, I'll say this too. I am not a big fan of demos as an analyst over many, many years. You know, demos a lot of times don't really resonate with me. But I remember last year I spent some time, because it was early agentic, still is, but some of the demos that you guys had on the floor last year were so instructive and so engaging. And so I would encourage people to check those out. They won't make your eyes glaze over. They will draw you in and get you to ask questions. I wonder, Michael, if you could engage me in a little lightning round here, and we can maybe do a little, you know, round the horn here.
All right.
Okay.
All right, I'm game.
I'm gonna throw some, you know, four or five things at you, and I want you to respond. So okay. Complete this sentence. Fusion is a win if attendees blank.
I'll go with what I just mentioned a minute ago. Come away knowing that their continued trust in UiPath is the best call they've made.
Okay, this is kind of a fastball for a marketing exec. What's the most overhyped marketing tactic right now?
Okay, video, but most overhyped and most relevant. I think that in marketing, we've moved really, really fast. We've been experimenting like crazy with video, broadly speaking, but now it's a jungle out there. So the best teams right now are going to get through that hype, and they're going to figure out what works and focus on high impact versus volume. That's the change that needs to happen now.
Yeah, authentic content always works. You're hitting home with the cube right now, Michael, with video. Okay, what's the most underrated channel for enterprise buyers?
Oh, most underrated channel for enterprise buyers. I still think that the voice of the industry analyst is maybe it's not fair to call it underrated, but it remains one of the most unique forums for the exchange of ideas between vendors and customers through a sort of mediator. And I actually really value that exchange and the tension that gets built between them. So I still believe in it as a vendor, and I think customers should believe in it.
Well, as a long-term industry analyst, I appreciate that. And I actually have to say I get a lot of value from my analyst colleagues and their insights. Okay, you're gonna love this one. You're gonna be up on stage. What's the one promise that you refuse to make up on stage?
Ah, okay. I think it is that I'd never promise a finish line. I think that a lot of people get on stage and try to explain the journey from a start to finish perspective for either vision execution, for product strategy, for roadmap. And I think I've learned over the course of my career that the industry demands that we move from one transformation to the next highly effectively. And in fact, our mission is to navigate transformation to transformation. So I will never suggest that there is a finish line. I will always talk about the path to the next transformation.
That's good. That aligns with your CEO, Daniel. He's always said, we're never done. And as a product guy,
we're still here.
He's never done, right? Okay, last one.
Yeah.
Finish this thought. Customer stories beat blank.
Well, just about everything. Spec sheets, how about that? Like, I think that every company goes through a transformation like this. It's not about what we built anymore. It's not even about what our products do. It is about how customers transform with them and through them. So it's customer stories beat everything.
Michael, so excited about this year's Fusion. It's September 30th. It's at the Wynn, awesome venue. Looking forward to it. Thank you so much for coming on and previewing Fusion.
Oh, man, my pleasure. Thank you so much, Dave, for having me.
All right, and go to the website, register for Fusion. It's going to be a great event. The Cube will be there. The industry's automation leaders will be there. You'll learn a lot. Thanks for watching, everybody. This is Dave Vellante, and we'll see you at Fusion 2025.